I'm Dr. Matt Schindel. I'm a curator here at the National Air and Space Museum, where I curate our collections related to Earth and planetary science. So after the end of the first era of robotic exploration of Mars ended in the 1970s, it took about 20 years before the U.S. started sending spacecraft to Mars again. And so in the 1990s, you started to see U.S. missions to Mars again. And there were a couple of missions sent during that time that unfortunately had poor ends. And one Mars spacecraft that had a particularly bad end was the Mars Climate Orbiter, which the U.S. launched in 1998 on the way to Mars. And when it got to Mars and when everyone was ready to celebrate the fact that it was going into orbit, suddenly NASA lost communications with it. And what turned out had happened was that the software on the spacecraft had a different software from the software that was being used at Mission Control, one of which used metric units and the other used English units, or feet and inches. And those two software were supposed to be able to communicate with each other, but because the numbers from one weren't being converted into the units of the other, the spacecraft either ended up burning up in the Martian atmosphere or speeding off, you know, out of orbit of Mars and ending up in an orbit around the sun. We don't actually know what happened to it, but we know that we didn't get the years of data that scientists were hoping to get from the Mars Climate Orbiter because we lost it. So this is why when we write down our measurements, it's important to actually indicate what units we're using. Otherwise, you could be communicating something very different from what you think.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.